गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, ऑनलाइन लेक्चर की सीरीज़ में आज हम शुरू करने जा रहे हैं ओरिजिन एंड एवोल्यूशन ऑफ एम्फीबिया। और यह जो टॉपिक है वो एमएससी सेमेस्टर थर्ड में बायोलॉजी ऑफ कॉर्डेट्स, जो कि पेपर 11th है, उसमें इंक्लूड किया गया है। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर कृष्णा मिश्रा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, सम्राट पृथ्वीराज चौहान, राजकीय महाविद्यालय अजमेर। ओरिजन एंड एंसेस्टर्स ऑफ एम्फीबियन। द अर्लीस्ट एम्फीबियन, अर्लीस्ट फॉसिल ऑफ एम्फीबिया दैट इज टेट्रापोडा आर नोन एज लैबिरिंथोडोंटिया बिकॉज ऑफ द फोल्डेड नेचर ऑफ डेंटाइन ऑफ देयर टीथ। दे प्रोबेबली ओरिजिनेटेड 300 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो during Devonian period, and after that they flourished through Carboniferous and Permian periods before their extinction in Triassic period. Then we will come to the ancestry of amphibia from Pisces, that is Piscean ancestry. It is universally accepted that amphibians, they have originated from fishes. Resemblance of amphibia to fishes is seen in most systems of the body. Both of they are cold-blooded, both respire by gills early in their life and in some cases throughout life. Both have air bladders serving as lungs. Like fishes, aquatic amphibians, they have a canal system. To prevent desiccation in air, both usually lay eggs in water where larval development usually continues. So, it was the similarities of fishes with the amphibians, and it shows that amphibians, they are originated from the fishes. Here you can see that how amphibians, they are evolved from fishes in various time scales. Devonian fishes. The three major groups of advanced bony fishes were contemporaries of Labyrinthodontia during Devonian periods, and these were Actinopterygii, Dipnoi and Crossopterygii. Out of these three, Actinopterygii, they are far off the main course of tetrapod evolution because of many specialization. Actinopterygii जो हैं उनसे tetrapod evolution जो है वो नहीं हुआ है, क्योंकि इनके अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा specializations जो हैं वो present होते हैं. Dipnoids, they have several features of close resemblance to amphibia in their anatomy and embryology, but they have also been too specialized to be considered as ancestral to amphibia. Particularly, the skeleton of their fins is not reminiscent of that of the primitive tetrapoda. Fins ka jo skeleton hai wo tetrapod se bilkul different hota hai. Thus, the older view that dipnoin gave rise to amphibians is no longer held. Their similarity probably resulted due to convergent evolution. क्यों होती similarity? It is due to the convergent evolution. On the other hand, it is now believed that the earliest amphibian that were labyrinthodonts, they arose from primitive Crossopterygian. Now we will come to the Crossopterygian ancestry. Origin of amphibia, it can be traced back to the freshwater carnivorous Rhipidistean Crossopterygian of Devonian period. It was represented by genera Osteolapsus and Euthenopteron. They show extensive morphological similarities with every amphibians and labyrinthodonts, which are evidence of their close phylogenetic relationship. Now we will discuss about characters. The pentadactyl limbs of amphibian is supposed to have arisen from the Crossopterygian fin lobes. Here you can see that the quiridium is the tetrapod's most basic characteristic. This limb is known for having the differentiated parts. The stylopodium, it is one bone, the humerus or the femur. Here it is, the stylopodium, which shows the bone, humerus or femur. Then zygopodium, two bones, the radius or tibia, and ulna and fibula. This one is the zygopodium area, radio ulna or radius or tibia, and ulna or fibula. Then autopodium, there are fingers, hands, toes and feet. This one shows autopodium, which contains fingers, hands, toes and feet. While the stylopodium and zygopodium, they derived from the sarcopterygian's fin, the autopodium is a newly evolved structure exclusively from tetrapoda. Their skulls and jaws, they are similar and can be equated bone by bone. Both Rapidistian and early tetrapods were predators. Both of them were predators armed with sharp, strong teeth with the peculiar labyrinthine enfolding of the enamel. Then position of external and internal nerves, it is similar. Air bladder were used as lungs during short migration from pond to pond. Ichthyostega, a primitive fossil which is found in Greenland, it has both crocepterygian and amphibian characteristic and represent a transitional stage. Then we will come to the possible polyphyletic origin. The three orders of living amphibia, they are Apoda, Urodela, Anura. They all are so different as to suggest a polyphyletic origin of amphibia. But Eric Zarvik supports a diphyletic origin. He suggested origin of Urodela and Apoda from porolapid rapidistian through Lepospondyli, a group of small carboniferous and Permian forms, while origin of Anura, it is from osteolapid rapidistian through labyrinthodonts. His views they are not accepted at all. Another view traces the ancestry of all three orders from lepidospindles. So this was about the origin of the amphibians. Thanks. Next, we will continue this topic in my next lecture.